Hi everyone, welcome to the presentation on strategic management. Today is the first lecture in terms of our online learning, and we're doing a video lecture on just understanding what strategic management is and why it is important and why you as fourth year students undertake this course. The outline of the presentation is as follows. I'll try to do just a brief introduction and then understand whose responsibility it is to carry out strategic management in any organization, and also why it is important, why is it significant, and then be able to do a bit of definitions, understand what strategy is and what strategic management as a process entails. Okay, so in terms of our introduction, we all understand that every organization, whether profit making or non-profit making, all have people we call owners of that organization. In terms of a business organization, those are referred to as investors. These investors stake their money into this business undertaking, of course, with the view of earning a reasonable return on their investment. Now, these returns are measured in terms of accounting figures. For bigger organizations, well-established organizations, they will have all these systems in place, accounting figures in place, which will range from maybe measuring the return on their assets, the return on capital employed, the return on their sales. For those of you that did a bit of financial accounting and corporate finance, one of the topics that you learned in finance is accounting ratios. And these accounting ratios help us to measure the performance of an organization in terms of its liquidity position or in terms of the efficiency, how the managers in that organization are utilizing the resources, the assets, or just trying to look at the gearing ratios. How much of the capital is in debt and how much of the capital is equity. So for bigger organizations, returns are measured in terms of those accounting figures. But what about smaller organizations? A lot of studies show that most economies, especially in the developing world, like in our setup here, the contribution, huge contribution to GDP is actually coming from the SMEs or small businesses. And one may ask the question, do these also mind about the returns on their investments and how they measure returns on their investments? For smaller businesses, returns will be measured in terms of the growth of that business and the rate of growth. When you start a business, your interest is to see that business grow and reach a certain level. So for smaller ones, returns will be measured in terms of the amount of growth and the speed of growth. So firms or businesses that do not have a competitive advantage will just earn what we call average returns. If you don't have a competitive advantage in an industry, the returns will just be average. And this is not a good position, because if you don't maintain that, you can actually have below average returns. So average returns are returns equal to those an investor expects to earn from other investments with a similar amount of risk. So quickly, why is strategic management important? And whose responsibility is it? Before we can look at this aspect, I just want us to understand the reason why we are doing strategic management in our fourth year. And the assumption is that as you take this course in your fourth year, you will have studied other business courses, prior business courses that build or feed into strategic management. So this is very important, whether we consider a professional program or an academic program, for one simple reason, and I'll be able to emphasize that that reason. So what normally happens is that these investors, when they invest money in a business, for a big organization, of course, they will appoint a board of directors or elect a board of directors who provide oversight that organization in terms of the general management to ensure that the business is managed in a way that serves the interests of the owners. Like I said earlier, owners are interested in getting a return on their investment. So the owners will not do the day-to-day management. That responsibility is given to the board of directors. Then the board of directors subsequently will appoint a chief executive officer, or who will primarily carry out this role of strategy management and ensure that the business is giving the shareholders the returns that they need on their investment. Now, if a firm does not have a competitive advantage, such a firm will not be attractive in an industry, and the owners of that business will not continue investing money in a business that is not giving them the best returns. So it's only those that have a competitive advantage that will earn above average returns. Now, that inability to earn above average returns, or even at least average returns, will result in a firm, you know, failing. So decline will come in and eventually failure. Now, failure will occur because the investors withdraw their investment from those firms any less than average returns. So it's very, very critical as we look at business in totality that owners expect a reasonable return. They give that responsibility to the directors, who subsequently, you know, give it to the CEO to make sure that the business is competitive. So firms with a competitive advantage are the ones that will aim to earn above average returns. So the concept of competitive advantage keeps coming, and later on we'll be able to explain what this concept entails and how a firm can achieve that competitive advantage. So from this slide, what we are getting is the idea that owners of the business will invest money in the business, they will appoint a board of directors to provide oversight in terms of governance of that business, then the responsibility of strategic management will be on the shoulders of a person we are calling the chief executive officer. So strategic management is a responsibility of senior executives in an organization. And from our knowledge in principles of management, you will recall that every organization in terms of management will have three layers. We have top management, we have middle management, and we have lower management. So from this explanation, we can clearly see that strategic management will be a responsibility of top management. And that's where we get these chief executive officers. Other firms will call them director generals or managing director, whatever the term. But this is a person who carries the responsibility for strategic management in an organization. So having said that, then, what is strategic management? I just started by giving general introductions and why it is important. So what is strategic management? Before we can even look at a working definition of what strategic management is, it is important to appreciate that most firms, business organizations, will use this process of strategic management as a foundation. A foundation upon which they will make decisions, a foundation upon which they will make certain commitments and take actions as they pursue their strategic competitiveness and the aim above average returns. this level of management or type of management we are talking about, it is a process. Strategic management is not a one-off activity. Like say, beginning of the year, we don't just say we are now going to engage in strategic management, 2 months later, you fold your arms and you're not doing anything. It is a continuous process. And we'll explain some of the steps that you go through in that process. But what we are seeing here is that business firms, organizations, will use this process called strategic management as a foundation upon which they are going to make decisions, a foundation upon which they are going to take actions and make commitments as they pursue that competitiveness. Remember earlier on we mentioned that a firm that has got a competitive advantage will earn above average returns. And that's the desire of the investors or owners of the business. So in pursuit of that strategic competitiveness, firms will use strategic management as a foundation or a platform upon which they're going to make decisions, take actions, and make commitments. Now, strategic competitiveness will be achieved when a firm successfully formulates a strategy and implements that strategy. Not just an ordinary strategy. Here we are describing or emphasizing what we call a value-creating strategy. Now, you'll recall in our course that I sent out some notes. Part A of the course that deals with environmental scanning and strategy formulation, and then the part B deals with the implementation of that strategy. So it is one thing to formulate a strategy, a winning strategy, value-creating strategy, but it is also another thing to see to it that that strategy is implemented. Therefore, strategic competitiveness will only be achieved when this particular organization is able to successfully formulate a strategy and see to it that that strategy is executed in a way that will add value to an organization. So when choosing a strategy, firms normally will make choices among competing alternatives as the pathway for deciding how they pursue their strategic competitiveness. You don't just come up with one strategy, or you don't just come up with one action. Normally, you'll be competing, alternatives. Just like any formal planning process, you come up with alternatives, do an analysis of those alternatives, then you can settle for one that will give you a strategic competitiveness. So that chosen strategy indicates what the firm will do, as well as what the firm will not do. I've summarized these slides in your notes. You will get a lot of explanations and illustrations to just understand the point. So from these slides, in a nutshell, we are saying business organizations use this process of strategic management as a platform. Others will call it a foundation upon which they're going to make decisions, take actions and commitments as they pursue strategic competitiveness. When you achieve that strategic competitiveness, you aim above average returns. What is strategic competitiveness? Strategic competitiveness is achieved when a business organization successfully formulates and implements a value creating strategy. So let's get a wiki definition of what strategic management is. Now, when you read different books, we have gurus in management, Drucker, Robert, Kretner, G. A. Cole, so many people, Scholes and others, they've given different definitions of management, or rather strategic management. Now, there are certain things that are common in all those definitions that are presented by different scholars, even the practitioners, people that have been practicing management for a long time. They've defined what strategic management is as well from their own experiences. And I've come up with what I'm calling a hybrid definition because I took out some of the common aspects in most of the definitions and put them together and simply define the strategic management as that set of managerial decisions that is very key and the actions that determines the long-run performance of a corporation. What is very key in this definition is that strategic management is about making managerial decisions, taking these managerial actions that will determine the long-term performance or long-run performance of a corporation. Meaning that strategic management has got this, you know, future orientation. We are more concerned with the performance of an organization in the long term. Now, when you talk of the long term, in terms of time limits, time horizon, many people say long term will be a period of 5 years and above. So if you are a strategist in an organization, your concern is the performance of the business the next 5 years, the next 7 years, the next 10 years, and so on. So, in terms of defining what strategic management is, and the definition we have adopted as our working definition is that it is that set of managerial decisions and actions that determine the long-run performance of the business. One author said that one of the distinguishing marks of any enterprising manager is the ability to make decisions. Decision-making is a very key function of management. We make decisions every day. Whether you're at operational level, at functional level, even at strategic level. So we see the aspect of managerial decisions being emphasized in this process of strategic management. Now, the study of strategic management, therefore, emphasizes the monitoring and evaluating of external opportunities and threats in light of the company's strengths and weaknesses. And I just want to explain why that is critical. So in strategic management, the emphasis is on monitoring and evaluating the external opportunities and the threats in light of an organization's strengths and weaknesses. Why that emphasis? The fact that we are more concerned with the long-term performance of an organization and from our knowledge of business environment in first year, we all understand the fact that the environment is dynamic. So the environment is ever changing. So we don't expect the environmental conditions to be the same throughout. So you can come up with a very good strategic plan. I know most of you in fourth year are already working, particularly the part-time and the distance students. You are working, you are in management positions, some of you. You do participate in the process of, you know, coming up with a strategic plan for your organization. You will discover that every strategic plan that an organization will come up with points to the future. So it will be a plan, say, for the next 5 years. Now, because you are looking at a plan for the next 5 years, the performance of an organization in the next 5 years, then the environmental variables here become very, very key. Because from the external environment, you can actually get what we call opportunities. Favorable conditions that will present themselves to you and that will enable you to make more profits, for example. Or from the external environment, you can get these variables we call threats. Conditions, situations that may threaten your business. They may pose a danger to your business. We are in this period of the COVID-19, this global pandemic, and we have seen how most business organizations, and not just business organizations, all organizations, how they've been affected by this pandemic, because various governments have come up with certain measures that are restricting the conduct of certain businesses. So for any organization that is strategic, this is a moment now when we need to sit down, go back to the drawing board, and start planning for the future. If this continues for the next 2-3 years, how are we going to conduct our business? Where do we need to make adjustments? So for some organizations, COVID-19 has presented threats. For other business organizations, you agree with me, COVID-19 has presented opportunities. We have seen a lot of business opportunities emerge in the midst of this, this pandemic. So in the environment, we get variables or elements that create opportunities, others create threats to a business, and that's why in strategic management, our emphasis, friends, is monitoring these environmental variables, externally and internally. And of course, when we look at our corporation's strengths, we are simply making reference to things like your own resources that you have as a business, capabilities that you have as a business, the core competences that are unique to a particular business, those will constitute what we call strengths. Then weaknesses are areas where you're not going to find. You have limitations as a business. For example, your financial capacity is not up to speed. You don't have a lot of money. You cannot embark on bigger projects. Or in terms of technology, you are lagging behind. That is a weakness on the part of an organization. Or simply put, you are trying to areas where you're not doing fine. Maybe of increasing numbers of customer complaints about your product, your service, that also can actually denote a weakness. So here what we are seeing, friends, is that strategic management emphasizes monitoring and evaluating these environmental variables. I've taken a bit of time here because I want you to understand, once we understand what strategic management is, the rest of the stuff will just fall in place. So it is that state of managerial decisions that you make, actions that you take, that will determine the long-term performance of the organization. Because you are future-oriented, you are looking to the future, therefore, the monitoring of these environmental variables become key to your organization. And I want to challenge each one of us, just take some time. Those of you that are working, look at some of these strategic plans that business organizations have come up with. You will always find a section where a comprehensive environmental analysis was done. And for most organizations, they find it easy just to conduct a SWOT analysis. Because the SWOT analysis will take care of both the external variables and the internal variables. So this study of strategic management will incorporate the integrated concerns of business policy, but with the area, environmental, and strategic emphasis. Yes, we are trying to look at policies that we can put in place, actions that we can take, decisions that we are going to make at strategic level. The emphasis also is on environmental issues. That's why for those of you that have been studying and you have gone through the process of strategic management, that's the reason why step number one in that process of strategic management is actually environmental scanning. Still on the definition, just to continue emphasizing some aspects, the term strategic management underlines the importance of managers. to strategy and to formulate these strategies, because these strategies will not just happen by themselves. So our emphasis in strategic management is that managers must formulate strategies. You can't call yourself a chief executive officer, senior executive in an organization, if you cannot formulate a strategy. Unfortunately, friends, for most business organizations, this important task of strategy formulation has been given to the people you call business consultants, outsourcing. So you bring in these people to formulate a strategic plan for you, and you don't have that ownership of that plan. Implementation becomes a challenge because there is no ownership. So the emphasis in strategic management is that managers must or should formulate strategy, because this strategy is not just happening by themselves. So strategy will involve people, again, emphasis here, managers, who decide and implement strategy. Managers must decide, meaning that they must formulate the strategy. Managers must also see to it that it is implemented. And I've heard many people, you know, say that, like in our context in Zambia, we come up with very good strategies. You visit most organizations, there are very good plans in place. But it's like implementation is a challenge. From personal level, at a personal level, at a family level, organizational level, even at national level, in most cases, implementation of strategy is a challenge. But people find it easy to formulate strategies. So to wrap it up on the and understanding what strategic management is that strategic management will include understanding three important components or aspects, and I want to emphasize this. Strategic management requires you as a manager, as CEO, to understand, number one, the strategic position of the firm. So when we say the strategic position of the firm, you must understand where you are now as a business. So understand the current strategic position. Secondly, strategic management requires you to understand the strategic choices for the future. And I've put those aspects in red and bold just to stress some emphasis. Once we know where we are now, then we can decide where we want to be, and those are the strategic choices that we are taking for the future. The third aspect of strategic management is to manage strategy in action. How do we then manage this strategy in action? Scores and the friends have said that strategy is about movement. You are moving from point A to point B. So if you are at point A and your desired position is point B, how then do you move from point A to point B? And that is the third aspect. So we can simply put, say that strategic management is about one, understanding where we are, two, where we want to be, three, how we get there. That's managing strategy in action. So let me end this lecture on the process itself, just to highlight some of the steps that you go through in this process of strategic management. Like we said earlier, it is the full set of commitments, decisions, and actions that are required for a firm to achieve strategic competitiveness and aim above average returns. So because it is a process, and I want to emphasize these strengths, any process of something involves what we may call stages or steps. I'm sure in our lower levels of education, from primary, secondary school, we've been exposed to so many processes. process of this, a process of that. So a process is like a cycle. So you go through steps, stages. And in terms of our strategic management, most scholars have identified four major steps of the process of strategic management. So because it is a process, our first step of this process has everything to do with the analysis of the environment, both external and internal environment. And from our earlier explanations, we are saying that it is important to analyze the environment because we want to identify these key environmental variables that may present opportunities or threats, or those that we may use as our own strengths and the limitations that are there within our organization. So this is to determine its resources, capabilities, and core competences. These are sources of its strategic inputs. So meaning that you cannot formulate a strategy, a strategic plan for the next 5 years without having to understand the environment in which you operate. Both, I mean, in understanding the external environment and the internal environment, what is it that you have internally that you can use to seize the business opportunities that are presented out there? And that's why we are saying that these resources, capabilities, and core competences, they will be our strategic inputs in the next stage of the process of strategic management, which is strategy formulation. So with the information that you get from step number one of your analysis of the environment, so you have this information that helps you now to look at the vision of the mission of the organization, the mission of the organization, and then you formulate one or more strategies. And I want to emphasize here, because I've seen a lot of scripts, students write, and the process of strategic management is jumbled. You start with maybe formulation or implementation of strategy. You can do that. The starting point, friends, is looking at the environment. Get the inputs that you need for the next stage of that process. And this process is presented in form of a diagram. I'm sure you have this diagram in your notes. Just check your notes. There's this diagram that explains the steps that you go through in this process of strategic management. So you start with the environmental scanning there, where we are looking at the external environment and the internal environment. That is always the starting point, because you want to appreciate the strategic position where you are as a business. That information you have there will help you if you're a business that is already existing, revisit your vision and your mission. Remember, every organization has a mission, every organization has a vision. And here, briefly, a mission just explains who you are, what you do as a business, the reason why you are existing. That's a mission. And that mission is drafted in form of a statement. Whereas a vision is some desired future state where you ought to be. So you're working towards that vision. Mission is explaining who you are. It's giving a business definition, processes that you undertake, customers that you serve, the reason why you are existing. Whereas a vision is your desired future state. So when you do environmental scan, you can then revisit your vision and your mission, and the next step will be formulating one of those strategies. So in that box, we've just given a few examples of some of the strategies that a business, a typical business, may formulate. We may have what we call a corporate level strategy, business level strategy, strategy to do with competition, strategy maybe to pursue an acquisition or a merger, various different types of strategies that are given there. So after formulating the strategy, of course, the next thing is to see to it that a strategy is implemented. And implementation of strategy, friends, is very critical. Like I said, many organizations have business strategy plans. Maybe even an organization where you are working, you have a strategic plan running up to 2023. But if this is your third year in that strategic plan since it was, you know, it was formulated, how much has been implemented? I think that's where we have a challenge. Now, to make sure that a strategy is successfully implemented, an organization must ensure that these things are in place. Number one, good corporate governance. If your corporate governance is weak, there's poor accountability, for example. There's no transparency. There's no disclosure of critical information. There's no fairness. All those tenets of good corporate governance are missing. You cannot achieve or implement, rather, that strategy effectively. The other one is to work on the organizational structure and the control systems. People have said that for you to successfully implement strategy, you must have a good structure. Because strategy will follow this good structure. If the structure is faulty, you cannot have effective implementation of that strategy. What about control systems in place? Control systems, issues of quality. If all those are not put in place, your strategic leadership, strategic entrepreneurship, these aspects enable us to successfully implement strategy. And once we know that, the result here will be achieving that strategic competitiveness, and you start aiming above average returns. And I think that's where we started with. That strategic competitiveness is achieved when a company successfully formulates this strategy and implements that strategy. So this diagram just gives us the whole process of strategic management. Okay, so I'll skip this, the vision and the mission. These are self-explanatory in our notes. I'm explaining what a vision is and what it is. It's a picture of what a firm wants to be in the future. This, I think, is easy. You can read. I've given some examples of vision statements for businesses. Like, for example, a business that is supplying mining equipment in Zambia, what would be their vision? What would be a vision of an institution of learning? So these are just some examples. I think here we may not spend much time. Just like we have a mission, I explain what a mission is. It explains what business we are in. And that's a challenging question. It's important to be clear. So this again is straightforward, and I've given some example of a mission statement. All right, so for this presentation, we'll end here. I'll do another lecture video just to explain the benefits of strategic management, and then we can move on to step number one, the process of strategic management, which will be environmental scanning. Thank you for your time.